Right, welcome to part 8 of the tutorial, and in this one we're going to be concentrating on drawing in this part of the ear over here, and this is going to be quite challenging because we have some pastel on the paper that perhaps I shouldn't have put on in the first place, but we're going to give it a go. So we're going to need some white, and we're going to just very carefully map in roughly where I want the hair. So you know, you can, if you remember early on in the tutorials, we had some colour under here already, so we've got an idea really of where this needs to be, and it all comes down. You can see there's some little lines. I don't know if you can see that just there that we originally had in, and we're really going to be drawing lots and lots of hair, and it comes up really from about here. A lot of it is curving round. Some pieces there. Lots and lots and lots of hair. Really shimmering down all the way over here. It's going to take a while to get all this to cover up. Now, I'm not going to concern myself too much with shape here. My bigger concern is this blue that's going to come through the white. So I'm going to play with that quite a bit over this course of this drawing, show you how to correct all that. Assuming we can figure it out as well. We've also got all this part here is very almost cartoony. Which we don't want on our finished piece. So we're going to look at starting to turn that into a whole mass of hair as opposed to what it is now, which really is a very mixed bag of, you know, shape and form and colour and so forth. So I really want to get some of these pencils a bit sharpened because there's a lot of fine hair. So you will need good sharp pencils when you come to start doing this part. Find out whether my pencil sharpener's decided to come back to life. Simple answer is nope. I'm not sure what on earth has happened to this, as I've said on previous videos. There we go, it's getting there. It's like I have to force it to. So we're not going to get a sharp point on this. Ooh. And what on earth has happened to my camera? Seems to have collapsed. Oh, there we go. Somebody could have shouted me. Perhaps I need to tighten that up a little bit. I've got the heating on, which suggests that it's melted down a little tiny bit. There we go. Sorry about that. Oh, right. So what I'm going to do, what I'm going to start with doing, is just really shading this part of the head up here. We're trying to bring some dark form into here. We need a darker brown than this, don't we? What have we got? It's going to complicate matters when we can't get any darker than we need to. Acutely aware here that I've got to blend backwards and forwards. I'm going to get my hand really mucky. I can't see where my glass paper's gone. One of the joys of working at home is having kids that come in play. I'll put this here. As you can see, I'm getting this muck on my hand already. It does feel like there's a hell of a lot of pastel on this paper. I can't feel much tooth, which is a little concerning. Now here, you'd think the logical thing to do would be to use lots of light browns, but there's not really much options where the light browns are concerned. They're going to give us the right colour. But you remember something hopefully I did on my last tutorial, which was to use a flesh colour. And that's pretty much what I intend to do here. So look at that nice dark there. I've got a nice dark patch in there as well. Just that dark grey will be good. Without being too black. I think what I'm going to do is use the dreaded black for the time being. I'm just going to really map in where I want these darker areas to be. So we've got, look at reference photo, we've got this nice piece coming down here that has this bit there. Probably gone far too shallow with that, but it doesn't really matter. We have another bit there. Another bit just here. Then all these bits sort of blend. Across over here a bit. Pieces there, and we have another tiny bit there. There's a tiny bit. There aren't many really dark areas here. There's one patch here. You'll see the form of this change as I start to draw in some of these darks, I hope. So what I've done originally will start to look a lot different as we start to make sure that it all works together. There's areas like this bit here, which will become part and parcel of each other. In theory. So here, let's start at this side. That seems like a good place to be. All this hair is coming down here. It doesn't start to get light till we hit this spot here. So there's a couple of lighter parts on it, but not quite in the same way that I've drawn on here. So let's get that old tortilla out again. Shall I use a big one or a little one? I think I'll use a medium one. Now what I want to do here is just really push this down as far as I can so that I've got some grip on the paper, I hope. You can see the form that was on here just a few minutes ago. It's nothing like it's going to look like in a minute. And that's the general idea. But we're just drawing a base. So let me see. That's going down here. And it's going to come a bit down there like that. And this. Lovely, some shadow, a few hairs coming in here, and this is almost a separate bit of hair that comes down there that's all lit up. So, really, not sure how I came to the conclusion that it should look like that, but again, that's why we're doing this bit. Right, now, I talked about that flesh colour, so let's try and find that. 1, 3, 2. I'm gonna give this a go and see what happens. Lines, and this is not sharp enough by any stretch of the imagination. So let's try and run it through the dark dying pencil sharpener. To get a bit of a nib on it. Start to draw some form. Very light hairs. And that really is all you need. You'll know from your reference piece where your hairs are going, and you'll continue to refine this as we do, as we go. Here we have this piece coming around here, which is quite thick, blends there, and then we have some pieces coming here. Now I've got to be careful, we haven't done that top area there yet, so I don't want to build too much detail up there, but I do want to add in just the odd bit of hair that comes down here. There we go. Very, very carefully, just going backwards and forwards across, looking at where I'm drawing. Very faint lines. And so the darks really come back up here then. So this needs to go into those darks. So let's just see if we can pull some dark in here. So this is light. Should have come like that, I believe. To be brown, and it's quite hard to get the brown, as we've discussed. But it is brown, not black. Biffrey, just to add in. Little streaks. So I'm continually building this up to really get this hair-like effect. Back to our funny pink colour. Children protesting that at this time of day, which is now 4 o'clock, he wants his lunch. Actually, first I think he said breakfast, which he could have had at breakfast time. He's too busy playing his games, as kids do. Oh. Got one hair. Another one coming right at the edge of this dark spot here. You see it's looking a lot less foamy like this now, a lot more hairy. Not sure if they're really words or not. Down here, it's much harder to get the shape and the look and the feel that you want. Certainly with the brightness I put on there, which perhaps I shouldn't have done. Gonna give it a go. That bit there. That's the tortilla. This hair down here does in fact stand out far more, but we need, I believe, a good dark base layer to get this to work the way we want it to. And then we're going to continue to use this fleshy colour to try and really bring it out. So. I think we're really getting the sharp edge I wanted on here. I'm going to carry on. That's dark down there. Keep re-adding in dark lines. One thing we're losing here, doing it this way, is that lovely colour that the dog needs to have. So it's just that horrible orange one that we don't want. I didn't want this one. No, it wasn't either of those, was it? It was this one. We think. This little one. Yep. I need to go back and look at my own tutorial to find out what blue pencils I was using. I may be using the wrong pink too. Bear with me. Dropped the pencil I'm looking for. Oh, and indeed I have. Is this the one? So what we're going to do here is just add in, very much like we've been doing, just the shades. Very, very lightly pulling this over the pink that we've just put on. A building up process, as you can guess. This I think I've lost. Part. Okay, so we're going to continue now just to work up here. Bear with me. I'll just shut the door because people forget what we're doing. I do need some real dark in this upper area over here. Pink again here. Okay, little one has been given a sandwich, so I can carry on hopefully for a few minutes. Trying to draw this mass of colour in here. Some of this is a little bit too obvious. There's so many parts of this that you almost can't do without doing other parts. It's quite... got a complex area to do. Good one. There's got to be a colour I can use that really does going to do. I'm going to experiment a little bit to see what works and what doesn't. Don't like the yellow. I don't think this is going to show up at all. Nope. I think the obvious thing to do here, or the only real option, is with these dark browns. I'm trying to get them leaving very slim areas of hair. Using the lovely little light grey again. Trying to decide really where to pull these hairs from. I'm using the grey here because I think I can highlight the grey a bit easier. Then I'll be able to highlight the white if I put it on. And because it's a slightly blue grey colour, I'm confident that we can make it work. Am I confident? I don't know. But we shall soon find out. Sort of comes, got a wispy bit there, these are all coming across here. In all sorts of different directions. the reference photo again is a bit lacking in detail because the background on it is very light. So as we're drawing these lines in, I can't really tell 100% where we're going, but we can get a general idea for it. And if we're just drawing lots of lines, we're getting a feel for the hair. We're going in the right direction. And as we build more and more lines up, we're building the depth again. That's going to come, yeah, probably down to about where I've got it here. Okay, just because there's a bit more to work on in those areas. I want my white again. I must have hidden it. That's the white. There's the white. Okay. This is not sharp, and I don't have a knife, so I'm going to be fighting a bit of a battle with this one. Pencil sharpener. Just be a bit more of a nib to work on. I'm going to want to afterwards add some browns into this area again. What I'll probably do is this area here, I'll come up to after I've done down here, I think. Two different directions here. We have this hair that comes out here. We have these hairs that come down here. Okay. Bits that come across here in between these darks. And going back to our pinks here, we can start to shade these in there a bit more easily. There that comes down here. So I need to add some browns in here, and I'm going to start doing that a little bit. So in a few places. Got that blue showing through, which I didn't really want to happen. Particularly. Yeah, this cold is not. Very good. I'm just building up some browns into there. Shade them out again afterwards. Probably using the old tortillon that I've been using throughout the tutorial. Back down here with a colour again. I don't like that, a bit too white there. Shade it down a bit. All I'm doing here is building up really fine layers, twisting the pencil as we go. Really just trying to keep a sharp point on it. The nice thing is with these, you can add these bits in and just keep refining little areas and building them up and taking them out and building them up. So here, you see, that piece there is just a little hair. Might even pull it across there. There we go. All these spots, you're gonna want these odd little dark streaks. As you've gathered here, it starts to get quite light again. But we've got this almost cartoony style locks, which actually look bloody awful. So we're going to start to pull those out as we go and start to try and create the same effect we've got here. There's still a bit more work to do over here yet. As we go. There we go. No visitor. So here. I want the appearance of a few hairs coming through here. Really knowing which bit to work off because you're balancing everything in these areas to try and make it all blend in okay. And here there's lots of little hairs that are going across and down and around, and you know, there's one coming around here, but we can't do that really until we've put all this detail in here, otherwise it'll all be lost. So let's start working down here a bit more. So we have this whisper hair coming from there down to here, all drawing into one. But we have another piece coming out underneath. So I'll try and map this in a little bit more carefully. So that piece of hair is really all one. I've made it into almost like two. Not quite sure how. And it starts off as two. Pink on. this there. Golden tints. So many different directions of hairs. There we go. See what I've just done there? Oh, to be careful. So what we've got here now is these funny patches that almost look like dreadlocks or however else you want to describe them. So we've got to make them look like hair that's in slight clumps. Oh, can we do it? That's the question. I believe we can. Maybe the bigger question should be, can we do it and make it look like it's meant to look? Probably not with these bloody pencils that just aren't really the right sharpness. Make some more of that nice yellowy colour in. Really are coming from all different directions. I'm not sure where I'm drawing from here. Worked. I'm not entirely convinced it's the colour I really wanted it to be. But adding in these little touches, dear me. Like sometimes it's easier to stand and bend over and feel like you're breaking your back to do these parts. Yeah, we've really... brought in this. Particularly liking this. However, if we all liked our own work, I think we'd all be struggling. There'd be many more starving artists. Should be coming up from there. What don't I like about this? I think... this area here. Needs to come up far higher. use this colour shifter a little bit. I prefer the tortilla on the stand, I need sandpaper. I need to get some better materials for some of these little spots. Just to sort of blend these. Edges a bit smoother. It's got this part here. Doesn't look right. Looks a bit better. A nice sharp tortilla is going to come in handy because I don't want to leave this line perfectly under that. But I want to fade that hair out a little bit. Reason being, I can really draw it back in very faintly. And hopefully make it look a little better. Still got a lot of work to do on this bottom area here, obviously. We'll start on that now then. And there's my pencil sharpener dead completely, so I'm going to have to pause and find
the knife.
Okay, now unfortunately my Faber-Castell 132, I've tried and tried and tried to sharpen it, but it's breaking all the way up, so I think that's a dead one. I might be able to use that edge there, but it's looking unlikely. So I'll carry on. I've got a couple of Carbofellos that are not really the same colour, but we'll have a play and see what we can do. Not good to run out of the colour you want while you're in the middle of doing a piece, but it is what it is. So I'll add some more yellow into this really. More into these areas that are coming down. Just little touches here and there. This part here isn't really how we want it. What I mean now by this is a much, much lighter pink. So I've got to press just that little bit lighter. Bit more of a point on this one. This is much softer. This is a Carbofello 681. trying to use that sharp edge. Just to pull in a few lines of hair down there. Shortly we'll need to start working on this other foot again as well, in order to start putting the hair detail over there. And I've got lots of little hairs in across here. So let's go back for now and start working back up on these, this hair on the top of the head. Might be an idea here because I want that really so this is soft pastel, as you can probably tell. These sharp square edges. Be real careful here. Not something I particularly like doing. And blend this over afterwards. A nice mess. I'm going to try this now. There we go. You can see what I've done there. Just added a sort of fine mist of hair behind the base layers, and what I'm hoping, if I could find the right pencils, is that when we go back over this now, we can just add some bit more hair detail in. sharpen my Caran d'Ache for a bit more of the white highlight here. Appears to be something sticky on the end of this, I don't know what. Trying to leave myself a good amount of nib on the end of that. And just very carefully spin it into a nice point. That's the idea behind it. There we go. And then I'll sharpen that on my pastel paper perhaps, if I need to. And this Caran d'Ache is a bit softer. Whether it'll be soft enough to do what I want to do here. Make sure that stays in a nice fine point, really. Not really clearing that blue, but we don't want to either because we've put it in other places. And now we're going to want to re-blend this here. So there's a couple of ways of doing this. We can do it like this with our pencils. And I'm just going to pull a few bits in. Want a bit of the loose brown, and we don't have much here. And of course, the pastel's getting quite heavy there. So, back to the old tortillons as soon as I can find the darn thing. You have to watch this because you get that edge mark and it ends up a bit ugly. Right, where did I put my pencil? There it is. Let's bring a bit of a point to this one again. great big piece of paper is a little bit big, really, but. Running out of grit over here now, really. really dark brown. It seems to have mysteriously sprouted legs. Only because I'm not having much luck with this one at the moment. Give his Carbothero a go. idea. Drawing in some of these slightly little pairs down here. Just add a little bit of highlight. And we need to draw in. Can't find my pencils to try them today. So I had some feedback earlier on. Someone saying that perhaps I shouldn't sing. That was quite funny. All these dark edges, but my darn pink. I think we need to leave this area for a little bit and go and start looking at this area here. Start mapping in some colours, so we'll do that in a few minutes, I expect. So I'm sort of looking at my reference photo and coming back and flicking backwards and forwards, as we do. I keep finding little areas that, to my mind, don't look right. So I'm going to try something rather drastic and hope it'll work. What I noticed is this whole area here, this is lit up, this part, it's pretty much in shadow. So I want to bring it back into shadow a bit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to colour it back in again, just very carefully, adding some more shade, leaving a few bits in there. Don't want to take it down completely. But I do want to make it just that bit darker. There we go, so I've darkened that area down a little bit. I just need to add some more dark shadows in between the hairs. So I'm just resharpening the black. It's got a bit blunt. And I'm just going to re-add in darker lines here. We're going to lose too much definition. just draw a few slight streaks in there, just to give it some direction. Let me have a quick gander at that. Just found out I've missed an important meeting, which I'm not overly happy about, but well, the joys of running your own business. The only reason I'm not in the office today and I'm doing this instead is because I seem to have developed this horrible man flu. What are they calling it? Australian flu? Really nice. Just what I wanted. Still can't escape from this horrible, there's a look to this that I'm just not sitting well with. Seconds.